As a CEO of ASCO, it's really important to me that our voice be heard. And this requires that legislators and regulators, both at the federal level, which we're used to thinking about, but also at the state and local level, know what it is we stand for and what it is that will be very best at helping us deliver the highest quality care to our patients. This requires a concerted effort. This really is a responsibility or an opportunity for every ASCO member. We can collectively carry our message forward with a whole lot more force than if we leave it to just a few people.
The more of us that are involved from diverse backgrounds, whether we're frontline clinicians, whether we're researchers, whether we're professors, if we can spread the message of cancer care from all different perspectives, I think it has a larger impact to policies that might affect patients and family members.
There are many issues that are facing us today in cancer, and many of those relate to how our legislature is affecting the billing and covering of our therapies and in research funding. I think it's important for us to go to Capitol Hill because there's power in numbers.
So it's not a one-time deal. It's a dialogue that you have. So you can call up the representative or their health aide, and so they know who you are. It's really helpful. And you'd be surprised that they take those calls very seriously. If you'd like, actually have them come out to the office. Have them see what you do day in and day out, how something that's being proposed in Washington or in your state could really affect how you practice and the care that you're giving to the patients. So I'd encourage you to develop those relationships. It's all about relationships.
The most compelling stories that regulators and legislators ever hear are the patient stories. And when we go in and are just telling the truth from our experiences with patients, when we can reflect our patients' experiences, we have the greatest impact.
As far as being an ASCO member and getting involved in advocacy, it doesn't have to be with a visit to Capitol Hill. It can be with grassroots efforts or letters to your congressmen or senators, because those letters matter. I think if oncologists are having a hard time keeping up to date with the bills and the policies that are moving forward, it's important for them to go on the ASCO website and look at the ACT Network, which is really an advocacy network led by ASCO staff that gives really up-to-date information about what we need to know in order to be able to confront or talk with our senators and congressmen about what concerns we have.
The risk of not getting involved is that the most expert voices will not be heard. And then the policies that we have to live with won't reflect what we know is best for our patients. To become directly involved in ASCO advocacy efforts, you can visit www.asco.org/ACTNetwork. That's ACTNETWORK, written as one word. And to keep up, to stay informed on ongoing policy developments, you should come back frequently to ASCO Action, one word, .asco.org.